no longer miss me. I stand with my friend Susan, scanning for theater seats, when I hear, Miss B? I turn to see a young woman, one of my students when I taught third grade. Her red hair has become straight and brown. Her face slopes at odd angles against my recollection, like a song played live, dissonant with the version my ear expects. Rachel? I have to look up to meet her eyes. You're so tall. I ask what grade she's in, 8th, and her favorite subject, drama. 5 years ago, she would have squealed, clapped, thrown her arms around me. Once, when I said I'd be away at a conference the next week, Rachel slumped in her chair and moaned, "Why? Why?" So I can become a better teacher. But that's not possible. She pounded her desk. Now she holds a playbill, nods vigorously when I ask if she still likes to write. But her eyes give her away. She wants to get back to her friends, and without the classroom's backdrop and pedestal, I am no longer Miss B. I wear blue jeans, my friend is waiting. Our smiles stiffen. There is nothing.